Researchers organize their research by formulating and answering a question. This helps them focus the research process so that they can draw conclusions reflecting the real world in the best possible way. An aspect of the attachment theory that highlights the importance of methodology is John Bowlby's maternal deprivation hypothesis, or the theory that breaking the mother's bond with the child during the early years will have intellectual, social, and emotional effects. An initial study undertaken by Bowlby at the time of the Second World War, commonly referred to as his study of 44 juvenile thieves, investigated the effects of maternal deprivation on juvenile delinquency. He interviewed 44 adolescents who were referred to his clinic in London because of stealing, and to act as a control group selected another group of 44 children with emotional problems but who had not committed any crimes. He interviewed the parents from both groups to state whether their children had experienced separation during the critical period and for how long. Each child had their IQ tested by a psychologist who also assessed the child's emotional attitudes towards the tests. At the same time, a social worker interviewed a parent to record details of the child's early life. The psychologist and social worker made separate reports. The findings showed that more than half of the juvenile thieves were separated from their mothers for longer than 6 months during the first 5 years, and that 32% were affectionless psychopaths, a term coined by Bowlby, meaning that they were lacking guilt or remorse. As a result of the research, Bowlby concluded that there can be little doubting that for the affectionless thief, nurture, not nature, is to blame. There is a very strong case indeed for believing that prolonged separation of a child from his mother or mother substitute during the first 5 years of life stands foremost among the causes of delinquent character development. Contemporaries of Bowlby working in the United States and also interested in the effects of maternal deprivation were René Spitz and Catherine Wolfe. They observed 123 babies for the first year of their lives who were being cared for by their unmarried mothers in a prison. When the infants were between 6 and 8 months, the mothers were temporarily moved to another block and the infants looked after by other people. During the 3 month separation, the child either did not see its mother at all or at best once a week. Each baby was looked after by the mother of another child or a girl in the later stages of pregnancy. Spitz and Wolf noted that the babies cried more, they lost their appetites and failed to gain weight. When they were reunited with their mothers, their conditions returned to what they were before the separation. The researchers concluded that these reactions were the result of being separated from their mothers. Harry Harlow, working with rhesus monkeys, wanted to study the cupboard love theory, or the idea that we attach to the person who feeds
us. Now here are 106s, two mothers. As you can see, it was weaned on a wire mother. Here's baby 106. Watch. He's going to the wire mother. He's got to eat to live.
Oh, he's going back.
He's back on the cloth mother, and he'll stay on the cloth mother. Actually, this baby spends from 17 to 18 hours a day on the cloth mother and less than 1 hour a day on the wire mother.
3 years later, Harlow reported on the same isolated monkeys. They were much more timid and did not know how to act when put in a cage with other monkeys and became prime targets for bullying. The conclusion Harlow drew from this study was that their psychological and emotional behavior suffered due to maternal deprivation. However, further studies that raised the same monkeys but allowed them 20 minutes a day with three other monkeys found that even this level of interaction was enough to teach them basic social skills. Harlow's research did not show that the infant monkeys were suffering from the absence of a mother figure or maternal deprivation, but rather from social deprivation. Similarly, many psychologists agree that short-term separation produces distress in children, as described by Spitz and Wolf. But there is a disagreement about the significance. In the long term, at least, the study could not prove that these babies needed their own particular mothers, but only showed how they become more agitated or depressed when their routines were upset or disrupted. Bowlby's study of 44 thieves involved a pre-selected sample from his own clinic and used retrospective evidence which could be influenced by distorted memories. Instead of considering any number of confounding factors, for example, the reason for the separation in the first place, like other researchers at the time and since, he saw a correlation and assumed a causation, despite the fact 27 of the 44 juvenile thieves had not suffered from maternal deprivation. The hypothesis that separation from an established mother figure in early childhood has a detrimental effect on a child's later mental health is widely promulgated and commonly accepted both in academic and lay circles. The hypothesis continues to have a significant effect on mothers' decision as to whether they should resume work and on governmental policy concerning the provision of childcare facilities. The evidence for this hypothesis does not satisfy the requirements of scientific methodology. The theory that a child's attachment to its mother figure is the emotional basis for its future love relationships is still accorded similar acceptance without further evidence than that supporting the original hypothesis.